John, welcome to The Narrow Path. Thanks for calling.
You bet. My question is, Paul says in the New Testament, to be absent from the body is to be present before the Lord. He also says earlier, though, that in the rapture, the dead in Christ shall rise first. If a person dies today and he's present before the Lord, is he aware of his presence? Or is it if your spirit goes into a state of just holding, like some of the, I forget what religion believes, that they're not aware of the fact that they're in heaven?
There are Christians, including, for example, the Seventh-day Adventists, who believe that when you die, your spirit is not consciously anywhere. Your spirit doesn't go anywhere. You're just dead. And then when Jesus comes back and he raises the dead and raptures the living Christians, that's when you come back to life. It's like you're sleeping until then, and then you wake up. That view is held by many Christians, and there's certainly nothing about it that would be objectionable. It's not what I understand the scriptures to teach, though. I believe the Bible teaches that we live in these bodies. That means what we are is not the body, but we're someone who's living in the body. Paul talked about a man he knew who had a vision. He said he was not sure if that vision happened in the body or out of the body. Now, although he didn't say for sure that it happened out of the body, he clearly believed it was a possibility. So Paul believed that a man lives in his body and is capable of being either in the body or out of the body. The body is more like a house. Paul uses the term a tent, referring to our present bodies. In 2 Corinthians 5, he says, if this tent of ours dissolves, he's talking about death, he says we have a habitation, a house in the heavens, not made with hands. So it's clear that Paul sees us as living in our bodies like somebody lives in a tent or in a house. And that when we die, we are then absent from the body. That means we've moved out, and the body then is buried and decays in the ground. Your question, are we consciously present with the Lord or unconsciously present with the Lord? I don't know. I've always assumed that he's talking about a conscious condition, but it could be not so much so. The main thing is that we are not in the body anymore, and we are now with the Lord. And it says in 1 Thessalonians 4:14 that when Jesus comes, God will bring with him, that is from heaven to earth, he will bring with him those who are dead, those who sleep in Jesus, as he put it. And when he does, he'll raise their bodies from the graves. He'll restore their bodies from the state of decomposition and transform them into a glorious body, an immortal body. And then those persons who have been with him, that is those who have died and been with him, he brings them back and puts them in their bodies again so that they're now in a glorious body. That's what the resurrection is.
Yeah, it's a little mysterious in that, you know, so many bodies over the period of years, and like myself, I'm 85 years old, and when I die, I want to be cremated. So what's happening to people that have been dead for years, they're back to earth, like dust to dust, and
exactly.
Earth to earth,
return. In fact, they may be parts of other bodies by now, because the atoms that are in your body, you know, may be eaten by fish or by animals by worms or something. And then those may be eaten by other bodies, by other creatures, and those may be eaten by others. So the atoms that were part of you in this lifetime may have become parts of lots of other creatures and even people, because there's stories about, you know, an apple tree growing in a churchyard where they found the root of the apple tree grew through a casket and through the body of a dead person, so that obviously the atoms of that body have gone into the apple tree. And so people who've eaten those apples, they got some of the same atoms in their bodies that were part of another body. So how does God work all that out? Here's what I would say, and I don't know how they would answer it before we knew about DNA, but how is it that I am the same person that I was 20 years ago? None of the cells in my body were present in me 20 years ago. All my cells turn over every 7 years, and yours too. So that means that there's not one cell in my body that was in my body a decade ago. They've all changed. So how is it still me? What is it that makes it still my body as opposed to a brand new body that isn't the same one? Well, a lot of it has to do, of course, with the soul that has remained constant through the turning over of the body. But more than that, the cells that have replaced the old cells have been formed and defined by the same DNA that was in me as a zygote in my mother's womb. When my parents conceived me, there was a certain DNA formula that defined me uniquely. And every cell in my body ever since has had that thing. What makes my body mine specifically is the DNA. In other words, God doesn't have to have the same exact cells or even atoms to resurrect me from that. He just needs to have the code. He just has to organize the matter according to the code of my DNA. And, you know, it may be that very few of the atoms that were in my body will be part of the new body, but it'll still be mine because it'll have that same DNA, I believe. This is, I could be wrong. Yeah. That's how I would solve that problem.
Okay, well, thank you very much.
All right, John. Good talking to you. I appreciate your call today.